Let's add some visual flair to the scene. I've built this little house, very basic, and I've also constructed a light that I will use in the house. And we can see that this light here, the material is emissive, but it is not giving off any actual light. The light is made of a simple voxbox with material plastic. It has the prop checkbox set to true, so it's dynamic. And I've added some emission by setting the fourth value here in the PBR parameters to 8. The fourth value is the setting for emissiveness. The voxbox has a rope attached to it. And the whole light is in a group where I've moved the origin so it corresponds to the end of the rope up here. Now with the light group selected, I can go into the building. And while pressing and holding P, I click there and the light is placed inside the building. Now I select the voxbox. I right click it, new, light. And I move the light so it's centered inside the shape, which represents a light bulb. I change the scale of the light to 8. And we can see that this ring changes as I change the scale. And this ring represents the reach of the light source. And since the light source is placed inside a shape, I will also increase the unshadowed volume, which is in meters, so I change it to 0.3. That means that no voxels within 3 voxels from the light source will cast any shadows. Now let's take a look. But the scene is a bit bright for the light to have any dramatic effect. So I go into the environment node. And we can see here that we have a template property. And the available templates to use can be found if we switch to Steam, right-click teardown, choose Manage, and browse local files. So this is the installation directory for teardown. I go into the data folder, and here is a file called templates. And I can see that there are a number of templates here defined for the environment node. There are also a couple of templates made for different materials. Night, that looks good. So let's try that out. Back in the environment node, I type night as the template. And now when we go into the scene, we have a night environment. I can also scroll down here and increase the amount of rain and the amount of puddles on the ground. And we have rain. Let's take a look at the different types of light sources in the game. First, we have the default sphere light, which casts lights in all directions. Then we have the cone. And I will have to rotate this. Like that. And the cone, just as the name implies, gives off light in the shape of a cone. We also have the area type. And with the area, the size parameters for the light source is in two dimensions. So let's type 1 by 1. And now we have a 1 by 1 meter large plane giving off light. And as you can see, the area light gives off much softer shadows than the point light and the cone light. Last one is the capsule. And the size parameters for the capsule is length and width. So this can be used for fluorescent lights and stuff like that. Let's enlarge the voxbox to match the capsule light. And those are the light sources that you can use in Teardown. Apart from the environment node, there is another node called the post-processing that can be used to affect the overall ambience of the scene. The post-processing node has settings for brightness, gamma, bloom, color balance, and saturation. So let's turn down the brightness a bit. And lower the gamma a bit to increase the contrast. We can also lower the saturation. And now we have a black and white game to play in. As you can see, when I created a light, I put the light source as a child to the voxbox, which is the emissive shape representing the light bulb. By doing this, if the voxbox breaks, then the light turns off as well. And that's all for lights, environments, and the post-processing node.